Alright, let's get into more juicy details about the gateway. Remember how I told you about my CAN shield? Well, I went ahead and combined the ESP32 DevKit 1 with the shield, and guess what I named it? The Gateway. The Gateway is simple and yet capable. It reads CAN messages from my car and sends them wirelessly using ESPNow, so I can make things happen. And to catch those wireless messages, I got those little receivers that I called gadgets, but that's for another video. Today, let's focus on the gateway. I'll walk you through how I connect it to my Model 3, but don't think I'm all about Tesla. I'll also show you how I hooked it up to the OBDII port in my Hyundai Tucson. The cool thing is, it should work for about any modern car out there. So here we go. Let's dive into the OBDII version first. I'm no OBDII expert, but it's a pretty standard port in most cars these days. You can usually find it near the steering wheel. Now, the reason we're after that port, it houses the most interesting CAN bus in the car. You see, cars typically have multiple CAN buses, but the one we are most keen on is the one in the OBDII port. It got all the data that we want, like the speed, dashboard lights, and whatnot. This port has 16 pins, but we're only interested in 4. 2 are for the CAN bus and 2 for power. And the CAN shield has the matching pins. So it's just a matter of connecting the dots. To tidy things up, I got myself an empty OBDII port plug and wired it all together. It ain't perfect fit, but hey, it works for now. I might design a fancy 3D printable case later, but I'm not gonna get ahead of myself. Before plugging in the gateway, I made sure it's in read-only mode. In my second shield version, I added a handy toggle for this. In the original shield, I had to manually connect 2 pins to achieve the same thing, but in version 2, it's just a toggle. Starting in read-only mode is crucial. I don't want to bombard the car with messages until I'm absolutely sure what I'm doing. The ESP32 gets loaded with a simple code that checks for CAN messages. When it sniffs one, it prints it to the console and sends it over ESPNow. I could have chosen different path, like Bluetooth or whatnot, but for this project, I stuck with the ESPNow. And that's the basic gist of it. I wanted to keep the gateway as straightforward as possible and save the fancy stuff for the gadgets. I played around with filtering, but it turns out the ESP32 can handle all the CAN messages like a champ, so no need to overcomplicate things. And most cars run at 500 kilobits per second for the CAN bus, so I kept that in mind while I was setting things up. Now, here's the kicker. The first challenge I faced was power consumption. The power pin on the OBDII port is directly connected to the car battery and it's always on. That means it, when I turn off the engine and I lock the car, the gateway keeps chucking along. You know how the ESP in normal mode can be battery hog, so I needed a solution. First, I tried a software-based fix. I kept an eye on the CAN bus and if I didn't see any action for a while, I put the ESP32 in deep sleep for a bit. Then I'll wake it up, check for messages, and put it back to sleep. Then rinse and repeat until I spotted some action. This little trick easily cut down energy consumption by more than 90% compared to doing nothing at all, as the majority of the time the ESP32 is simply in deep sleep. The whole thing worked like a charm because I noticed my car stopped sending CAN messages after it has been off for about 5 minutes. Luckily, I haven't run into any issues so far. I even went on a long vacation leaving the gateway plugged in, and when I got back, the car started without any hiccups. So that was good news. Now for the second solution. I tinkered with the hardware for this one. I updated my shield with a voltage divider to keep an eye on the battery voltage. The original idea was to put the ESP32 in deep sleep when the battery gets low. But guess what? I ended up using it for monitoring the alternator instead. Whenever the alternator kicks in, the battery voltage spikes and stays in a specific range, telling me that the car is running. With this trick, I can switch the ESP32 between deep sleep and normal mode. Both of these fixes do the same job, saving energy while the car is off. That means I can keep the gateway hooked up to the OBDII port all the time without worrying about draining the battery. Okay, now let's talk about the Tesla setup. connecting the gateway to my Tesla was actually simpler. Surprisingly, I didn't have to worry about energy consumption, because Tesla takes care of it for me. When the car goes to sleep, it cuts off the battery to the gateway automatically, so no need to fiddle with putting the ESP in deep sleep, the car simply takes care of it. Initially, I was a bit concerned about accessing CAN bus because most Teslas don't have the OBD port, but I discovered that the CAN bus I needed was right behind the center console. All I had to do was tap into four wires. To make life even easier, I found this awesome adapter that makes the connection plug and play. Oh, and by the way, there are two versions for this adapter depending on the model year. Mine uses the blue plug version here. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I have been using PCBWay for years, and they are my go-to manufacturer for all my prototypes. I've been averaging a week from the time I place an order to the time I have them in my hands. I'm very happy with the quality so far, and ordering PCBs have come a long way, especially for hobbyists. So I encourage you to give them a visit. I will put a link to their site down below. Since I'm running two gateways in two cars at the same time, I tweaked the code a bit by assigning a unique ID for each car in the ESPNow packages. This move lets me easily separate messages from different cars when I need to, or if I feel like it, I can mix all of them together. Oh, and by the way, those numbers you spot here are totally random, they don't mean anything. If you're curious why I'm assigning IDs to the ESPNow structure, you should totally check out my other low power sensors project. In a nutshell, I've set up an ESPNow gateway that forwards all the ESPNow messages via MQTT. That's why I use the same ESPNow structure for all my projects, so I can get them all funneled through one gateway. Now that I have those set up and have a stream of messages coming from my cars, it's time to start building those receivers. So these gadgets will simply decode those CAN messages and do some magic with them. So get ready, cause the next thing I'm gonna dive into is all about those gadgets, so stay tuned. Oh, and here's some good news, the CAN Shield is back in stock, so if you're up for some experimenting, you should totally grab one and join the fun. Thank you for watching and catch you in the next update.